I've seen my fair share of bad movies this year, but I have finally seen a brilliant bad movie. You know, a film that's trying so hard to be taken seriously, but unintentionally backfires on itself, so you end up having a great time. I took my friend Ben to see Welcome Home a few nights ago, which stars Aaron Paul of Breaking Bad fame and Emily Ratajkowski of Blurred Lines fame, and we had an unexpectedly great time watching this atrocity of a film. Let's talk about Welcome Home. Such fun! Hey up guys, so today I'm going to be talking about Welcome Home, the new thriller, if you could call it a thriller, which is directed by George Ratliff and is written by David Levinson. It tells the story of a young couple called Brian and Cassie, who are played by Aaron Paul, and the Blurred Lines chick, who take a trip to Todi in Italy to try and fix their domestic issues. And they rent this beautiful Airbnb in the Italian rustic countryside, and what should be a romantic renewal of their love turns into something very sour. Their neighbor Federico, who's played by Riccardo Scarmiccio, comes to Cassie's aid when she hurts herself on a run. But because of a previous infidelity that Cassie committed, Brian isn't too happy about this hunky Italian man coming to her rescue. And with good reason. As the film progresses, we learn of Federico's more sinister motives. I'm not dense, guys. I know what I was letting myself in for when I went to see a film with a poster as straight to DVD as this. The only reason I wanted to go see this is because I am a fan of Aaron Paul, and besides BoJack Horseman, his post-Breaking Bad career hasn't been as A-list as we'd hoped. Welcome Home is the type of film you'd expect Aaron Paul to be making before he got famous from Breaking Bad, not afterwards. It's just this poorly written, generic thriller without any thrills. But having said that, I still enjoyed watching this film. I think it falls into the it's so bad, it's good category. Right from the start, I love how melodramatic it is. The introduction to this movie is hilariously over the top. Never has anybody made booking an Airbnb look so dramatic. We get these tense, ominous strings as we see a mouse scrolling over a web page. Make booking. Click! It's so serious on its intent to be doom and gloomy and sinister, but I just found it hilarious. Director Ratliff also loves some loud jump cuts. Like, one minute you'll be watching Cassie and Brian just sitting on a sofa chatting, and the next, boom, you'll just cut to Federico watching them on a CCTV screen, and you'll just hear this loud boom, just to reiterate, this is supposed to be scary.
Loud noises!
If I'm to scan this film for actual positives, I would say Aaron Paul and Blurred Lines chick do have a believable enough chemistry, but I wouldn't say that the acting all around is amazing. Probably because so much of the dialogue is melodramatic, eye-roll inducing, and just very wooden. But Riccardo Scarmiccio, I've literally never seen him in anything, and after watching this, I can understand why. As far as antagonist goes, he's about as bland as they come. He does do a good creepy stare, but yeah, that's not enough to make a fully dimensional character. Being a creep, you know, there's no substance to him, and that's probably because Levinson's script doesn't actually give him any backstory to work with. He probably just showed up on set and the director just said, okay, you're a creep. Go with that. And I also love how contrived this film gets. There's a scene towards the end of this film where the three of them have just shared this super awkward dinner and Federico's diabolical plans start to come together. And he essentially frames both Cassie and Brian to make it look like they've both been cheating on each other. And I'm like, what? What is happening? Why on earth would you go to this much trouble to make a couple break up? It's convoluted and unnecessary. It's so stupid. But it only gets better from there. The last 20 minutes of this film is the most farcical bit of cinema I've seen all year. I want to talk about it. And it's gonna be spoilerish, but I'm gonna talk about it. So if you don't want it spoiled for you, now's your time to leave, okay? You've been warned. Right, so the last 20 minutes or so are just absolutely priceless. I don't know if it was intentional, but I was hysterically laughing during the final few scenes of this film. It just takes this very harsh turn in tone during the last 20 minutes of the film when it's building towards its showdown between Brian and Cassie and Federico. And in order to protect themselves, they end up having to kill Federico. And the way they kill him, I was howling at the screen. It just shows you Cassie basically clubbing him to death with a walking stick about 30 times. And it's like something from Tarantino. It's so gruesome and bloody and over the top, even though the tone of the film is saying, oh, it's supposed to be a serious dark moment, and it's just not. It's just a masterclass of misfire. Every choice just has this unintentional side effect of being hilarious. Like when Cassie cleans up Federico's blood and she just literally plops a rug on top of it. There, done. Literally sweeping it under the rug. I'm not making this stuff up. I had to grab Ben's leg in the cinema as if to say, is this really happening right now? Oh my god, we had a right giggle afterwards when we discussed this film over a pint. I think the first thing that Ben said to me was, well, that was an experience. And he was so right. I don't think I've ever had an experience like this in the cinema before. It was something special because of how bad it was. To sum up, guys, Welcome Home is a dire film, but it's somehow enjoyable. I think because it was trying to be sincere as a chilling thriller, but just grossly backfired on itself, resulting in it being unintentionally hilarious. It's a bit like Tommy Wiseau's The Room. It was made with honest intentions, but inexplicably is gloriously tragic and fun to watch because of how tone deaf it is. Okay, so let's ask those three questions. Would I watch this again? I can't believe I'm about to say this, but yeah, I think I would watch this again at some point. I kind of want my friends to see it just so they can experience the same joy I felt when I watched this with Ben. So I might just have to force it upon them. Would I recommend it though for you guys? It's a bit of a paradox because I know how abysmal this film is, but there is something special to just how bad it is. It really is a so bad it's good kind of film. I'm not recommending it because it's a well-crafted piece of cinema. I'm recommending it because of the experience you'll get from watching it. And what score am I gonna give it out of 10? Oh god, how do I score a film like this? Because I know it's so poorly written, the direction is questionable, the acting is a bit of a joke, it's tone deaf, and it's so melodramatic, but I was still entertained. So it's tough to score because I know it's a disaster, this film, but I still have some guilty pleasure love for it. It should be a 1 out of 10, really, but because there is some entertainment factor to it, I'm gonna boost Welcome Home up to a score of 3.5 out of 10. There you go, guys. Those are my thoughts on Welcome Home. I'm kind of hoping this review encourages a few of you to check it out, just out of curiosity and for the lols. If you have seen this film, be sure to let me know what you thought of it in that comment section below. If you guys do like this content, don't forget to click that subscribe button. And if you want to follow us on Twitter, Instagram, or Stardust, all that information is in the description link below. Thank you so much for watching, guys. For more things related to movies, TV, and popcorn culture, I'm Luke Hayfield, and I'll see you next time.